Hi, it's Katy Perry, and you're on RollingStone.com. Well, a lot of people have this idea that my parents are, you know, the like black and white collared kind of priest-esque background, but really, I mean, my parents come from a very charismatic. My dad's from Memphis, so he has a bit of that Pentecostal flavor. My mom is like, well, she's from Santa Barbara, so she's, you know, she's from West Coast a little bit, and together they're very much cool. Well, my mom didn't date Jimi Hendrix, but she hung out with him. And yes, my dad did sell acid for Timothy Leary. He always says Strawberry Fields Forever, baby. And they definitely had their wild child, probably even more intense than anything I've ever done, moments. You know, my dad's told me a lot of stories, and they call that a part of their testimony. Like, they talk about all that when they go and they speak to other people and the things that they went through and how they found God and how God has changed their life for the more positive and for the better. And, you know, my mom isn't the rock and roller, you know, pot-smoking debutante that she was, and my dad's not the acid dealer with long hair anymore. Well, I'm going to start my new record in September, October. Basically, what I want to do is not alienate the audience I have at all. I think some people feel like they have had success with one thing and one idea and one record, and they want to pull like a 180 and do a totally different thing. I definitely think that's the wrong move. I think you just have to like grow from it. You know, you have to branch off a little bit, but keep the tree the same in some ways. But definitely keep it pop. Like, some people are like, well, what kind of thing will it sound like? Well, maybe something like Loveful by the Cardigans meets Get Into the Groove by Madonna, but with a little bit more meat on the bones as far as lyrically. You know, I'm not going to just talk about the beat, and I'm not going to just talk about dancing, and, you know, just, I like to get into the lyrics and have them, you know, have puns and double entendres and different readings. I like to make people think. I think the second record for me is really important because it'll show either that I got lucky or that I was meant to do this.